黑洞、引力波、时间旅行，科幻电影中的元素却是科学家们多年的研究方向。12月15日，记者在北京举办的钛媒体2018全球创新大会上见到了2017年诺贝尔物理学奖的获得者基普索恩。2015年9月14日，由索恩作为主要创始人的科学合作组织探测到了首个引力波信号。近日，该团队在美国宣布，他们又探测到四次由黑洞合并时产生的引力波，其中一次是迄今为止最大、最远的黑洞合并事件。基普索恩说，最大的黑洞合并发现于被忽视的数据。
We thought we had found all of the signals in our data a year ago. But in fact, going back over the data, the team, particularly a group of young people working in the LIGO-Broca collaboration,dug out of the data, four more black hole collisions that were buried in the data, including this biggest one where the two black holes collided to make a merged black hole 80 times heavier than the sun, a gigantic black hole, that we missed in the initial data. And so it just shows the power of looking very, very carefully at data that you've already studied.And searching with better algorithms, better techniques, and you see things that you missed.
1916年，爱因斯坦基于广义相对论就预言了引力波的存在。基普索恩说，宇宙中的引力波非常微弱，它们对人类没有直接的影响，更多的是告诉人类，宇宙与我们想象的完全不同。除了物理学家外，基普索恩还是科幻电影《星际穿越》的科学顾问，时光旅行也成为了不少太空迷的向往。基普索恩说。他和霍金都从很早就开始研究时光旅行的理论，但他们都认为这不太可能。
Back in the late 1980s, and Stephen Hawking also started to work on it at about the same time. And in the end, we came to the same conclusion that probably the laws of physics prevent you from ever going backward in time, but we can't be sure. We found a mechanism, a way.That whenever any advanced civilization builds a time machine, the time machine might destroy itself when you first turn it on.
索恩也表示，他希望有年轻一代的科学家继续研究这个课题，得到完整的最终答案。在他看来，人类对宇宙探索的下一个台阶是对其他星球的探索。
The next step for human beings to actually themselves do the exploration is the exploration of other planets.Interplanetary travel and building colonies on other planets or on the moons of Jupiter and Saturn on the surface of Mars. I think this will happen. It will happen in this century. It may happen initially on Mars in the next 20 or 30 years. I think that's very possible if that's what we choose to do with our resources.
索恩还表示，虽然霍金曾警告人们不要过度研究外星生物，但他却持有相反意见。
When you look at how fast human technology has developed over just decades, or 100 or 200 years, I think you have to recognize that any alien civilization that we might encounter will be far, far, far beyond us. So much more advanced that they won't much care about us. That we may be like amoeba, like microbes to them. And so I don't worry about an alien civilization being hostile. I worry about consequences of their not caring about us and their accidentally causing